Now, London's Savile Row buses with activity as tailors race to prepare the red and gold uniforms for the troops for the coronation of King Charles. The capital's bespoke tailoring scene has been adorning ceremonial uniforms with the new insignia of King Charles ahead of Britain's first coronation in 70 years. Tailoring houses that cater to the royal family place particular attention on the king's well-known regard for sustainable, slow fashion. An American royal superfan is now in the United Kingdom, hoping to secure a front row seat to watch King Charles III's coronation on Saturday. Donna Werner is no stranger to royal celebrations. For more than three decades, she has traveled to Britain to witness major royal events like weddings and jubilees. Now she's in cloud nine to be in London for the first coronation, her first.
This is such a once-in-a-lifetime experience.
The first time I ever came for a royal event was for Fergie and Andrew's wedding, and that was in, I think, 86 or 87. And actually, I was pregnant at the time, but I came anyhow. And then after that, I came for Will and Kate's wedding and Harry and Meghan's and the Queen's couple of her jubilees, some of her birthdays. And it's just, nobody does it like the British, the pomp and the circumstance. And like I said, we don't have anything like this in the States.
Now, thousands of film and TV writers head to picket lines, sending Hollywood into turmoil and disrupting production. This is their first strike in 15 years. The Writers Guild of America, which represents over 11,000 writers, staged the work stoppage after failing to reach an agreement for higher pay from studios such as Walt Disney and Netflix. Writers say they have suffered in the streaming boom with shorter seasons and smaller residual payments.
The studios seem completely out of touch with what's going on with their workforce. They have not recognized that this change in the business to a streaming model, where, by the way, they are still incredibly profitable companies, and yet they have harmed their workforce, that there's just been no recognition that they need to make real systemic change in order to continue to have a stable and available freelance workforce that makes for them the most profitable entertainment content in the world.
A Filipino high school student who received full scholarship offers from five top U.S. universities finally made a choice. That is Harvard. University of the Philippines Rural High School student Carl Odric Guia had received offers from the University of Notre Dame, Yale, Harvard, Princeton, and Stanford. He ultimately chose Harvard because it offers astrophysics. Wow.
Aside po dun sa very big po na astrophysics center nila called the Smithsonian, I really resonated a lot po with the communities of Harvard. At this t-shirt po actually, galing po siya dun sa alumni ng Harvard ng Philippines. And I just thought na I resonated a lot with the values and I really felt like I belong to the community.
Guia is just waiting for his travel documents and visa. He will travel to the U.S. by the second or third week of August. Filipino boxing legend Manny Pacquiao ordered to pay $5.1 million for breach of contract. A California jury sided with Paradigm Sports Management, which sued Pacquiao in 2021. The sports management company that represents UFC star Conor McGregor had signed Pacquiao in February 2020 with talks of a possible mega fight between Pac-Man and McGregor. Last year, Pacquiao countered the said lawsuit with his own cross complaints, saying Paradigm failed to deliver on fights, endorsements, and complete a $4 million advance. Finance leaders in Asia calling for vigilance amid potential spillovers from the banking turmoil hounding the United States and Europe. They urge monetary authorities in the region to consider the impact of financial stability when formulating policies.
Balance between monetary policy for price stability, macro-prudential policy for price stability, that need to be be discussed and formulated optimally.